What was your question?
Talking about how sometimes we don't know a test to be we don't know a test to be fully accurate. You're unsure of the of how something feels.
Right.
And you decide to proceed as if just
are
in case.
Are your tests reliable?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's not look at like at a task being reliable the way that the research would look at it. Let's look at it as a process. I think you're going to I don't think that we can say that one test is more reliable than another, or you know, it's going to come down to your execution, obviously. And so it's going to be a process. Your reliability in testing is going to be a process. How do you know you're doing your test well? I mean, we have rules and such that we would use as we're doing our test, and we're going to follow those as we have been taught. But ultimately, you're going to evolve your process. And if you're good at it, and you want to be good at it, you will become more and more reliable with your testing. That's one of the reasons why I have you do so many reps. Why do you take all these measurements? Because I want you to make mistakes, and I want you to be, you know, accurate and get better and learn and all that, right? So I don't expect it to be perfect. And I'm not perfect when I do my tests. I make mistakes too. But we get more and more reliable based on the process that we go through. So it's not whether I'm executing this test perfectly. Am I executing the test well enough that I can make an effective decision, perform an appropriate intervention, and get that desired outcome? Then I can make my association and I say, oh, I did that test correctly. Rather than saying, well, this test is reliable, this test is not, the way we would look at it in the research, you know, asking a test whether it has inter-tester reliability for me really doesn't have much impact. It's whether you can consistently execute tests that are useful, mm-hmm. allow you to make good decisions, and then make good interventions that, you know, achieve the desired outcome. Whatever that may be, whether it be movement related or ultimately to, you know, promote a healthier human being.
And can you speak to when sometimes you're unsure of a test, like that test is just on the border, like something doesn't feel right about it?
If there's a question mark, always default to the negative.
Like negative.
This is so this test is positive. They don't pass.
Mm-hmm.
Treat them appropriately, and see what happens. It's much better fail safe to go in that direction than to say, oh, it's close.
I'll give it to them.
Like don't give them a gimme.
And then your retest confirms whether you were right or wrong the first time, only strengthening your own reliability.
Exactly right, and that's how you start to make the associations of, I need to clean up this test, or I need to execute this better, or I made a bad decision. Did I misinterpret what I was doing?
Right.
Those are the things. And again, it's just going to be it's a process and part of your evolution. And that's why you're allowed to get frustrated now.
Because I can.
Because you can.
Cool.
Does that
yeah.
point us in the right direction?
Points us in a phenomenal direction.